So you want to have your own Garry's Mod server for you and your friends to dig around on? Well, you came to the right place. In this video I will show you the easiest way to get this done. Well, let's just jump straight into it. Let's start off by opening your internet browser of choice. I will be using Google Chrome. Using your search engine of choice, look up Steam CMD. Click on the first result. Once on the webpage, you should click Windows. Once there, you will see the option to download the zip file. It is a little link, you will see it, it's shown on the video as well. Once that's done downloading, go to your local disk C by using the Windows Explorer and create a new folder there called Steam CMD. The capital letters don't mind if you care. Created that folder? Awesome! Let's go to your downloads and get that Steam CMD zip file and extract the steamcmd.exe file into the Steam CMD folder. Okay, I guess you're with me so far. Hang on a second, it's gonna get a little more difficult, but it's all gonna get easier from here. So, once you have done that, go down in the description of this video. Down there will be a little script you can copy. Copy it. That script will be called SteamCMD Update Script. Once you've copied it, open your SteamCMD folder again. Right-click, New, Text Document. Open a text document and paste the script in there. Make sure to remove the quote at the beginning and the end of the script, as shown in the video. Once you've done that, save the document and close it. Okay, awesome. Now, you will need to edit the file extension for this to actually open, because double-clicking it now will just open Notepad, which is not what we need to run a Garry's Mod server, is it, smarty pants? To accomplish this, click View. Click File Name Extensions and click the checkmark next to it. Now you will see file name extensions like DLL, EXE and .txt. Rename the .txt file to a .bat file. That is B-A-T. Okay, you've done that, awesome. But hang on a little second with double clicking on that file or opening it or doing anything with it. First off, I want you to go back to your local disk C, the main directory as shown in the video, where you will see program files x86, Windows, Users and Program Files. Those folders, they're probably there. Right-click, New Folder and call it Garry's Mod. One word, a little apostrophe thing, no spaces, capital G. You will get why this is required in a second. Once that folder is created, as shown on screen, capital G, one word, no spaces, Garry's Mod. Okay, done that? Awesome, open the SteamCMD folder again and run the Steam Update bat. Or whatever you called it. It will now log into the Steam service anonymously. This basically means you're logging in as a public user. It's a pretty nifty feature. It means you don't have to enter your Steam guard key and all that garbage. Once that's doing its thing, you will see that it's updating app 4020. This is the dedicated server from Garry's Mod. Most YouTubers and most how-to videos make you do this manually. I'm not gonna make you do that, I'm just gonna let you run this script. It's a little trick of mine, it's quite simple. To be frank, it's way easier to update the game this way than any other moron I showed you so far. Okay, let it update. Depending on the speed of your internet connection, this could take up to, yes, 1 hour. And then we haven't even downloaded the add-ons yet. More info on that in a second. Okay, done with that? Great. Let's continue. Open the Garry's Mod folder we created. And if you're not done downloading, just click pause on the video. We'll save on some bandwidth. Okay, you opened the Garry's Mod folder. Great, there should be a file there called srcds.exe. That file is to open your server, but we will not be using that file. You're probably confused now and asking why we're not using that file. Well, let me explain. I also created a nifty little bat file for you all. Again, different than what most morons recommend you use. Let's insert it into the folder, shall we? Down in the description, there will be a part called Garry's Mod Startup Script. This will be what you use to run your server. Copy it. Create a new text file. Right-click, New, Text Document. Once that's created, name it Start Server. Don't rename the file extension yet. Open it in Notepad. paste it in, remove the quote at the beginning and the end of the script. A quote, by the way, it's shown in the video what it is, I remove it as well. I know some people don't know what quotes are. Once that's done... Okay, so now we'll be editing the script just a little bit to accommodate workshop add-ons. Allow me to explain. So when you open the script or the txt file currently, you will see that it's pretty filled, obviously. But it says the map, in your case, I will make sure the script says gm_flatgrass, which is the default map of Gary's mod everyone has. If you wanna change that, I'll show you how to do that in just a second. But the most important thing is the host workshop collection. What this does is actually quite simple, allow me to explain. If a server has add-ons, which all of them do, well, they need to be coming from somewhere. These days they all come from the Steam Workshop. You can make a collection of add-ons even if they're not yours, and then they can import them into Gary's mod. Nobody shows you how to do this, but it is quite simple. Let me show you. Come along. You open Steam up. Go to your library. And you look for Gary's mod, which is right here. You click Browse the Workshop. Might depend on what Steam skin you're using, but I'm using Pixel Vision 2. Then you go to your profile icon right here, your profile pic. And you see your files, and you go to files you've posted. You click that. Once there, go to collections. You can either create a collection, which is totally a possibility, but that's not done from here. I already made a collection. What I then do is right click, copy paste URL, open Google Chrome, right click, paste, and then click enter. And this is the ID that I need to insert the workshop into my server. So as you can see, it's already in here. I'll remove it, there has to be a space, so plus host workshop collection, space, paste. The space will already be there, this will already be there, just collection ID will not, because it's a unique identifier. Let's just say you don't even have a collection. You're like, hey, Svec, I don't have a collection, what do I do? Well, my good boy, let me show you. You go to browse, you go to collections, you click create a collection, and you give it a title. Make it something catchy. Select the branding image. As you can see, we all use trash, so it doesn't really matter. Then you describe your collection, just don't. It's not really necessary if you're not going on a public server. Items that work together. And then select server content down here, just to make sure you don't spam the Steam Workshop. It's shit nobody wants to see, well, it's essentially what this is. Nobody wants to have this except your friends and you. Then you click save and continue, you select which add-ons you want in there. If you only have a couple, that you are subscribed to at the moment, don't even worry about it. And then that's that. Let's say I want to add the prop pack by Stalker, the Stalker prop pack. Well, I would click add to collection. I would click test for it, which is my collection I created a little second ago. And it should be added. So here we go. I'll go back to the workshop page. Go to your files you've posted. Go to collections, test for it, which is my collection. You should see the Stalker props pack is now in there. I also added a map for completion's sake, so let's say I added GM Golden City Day, actually quite a good map by Scarion, really recommend it. Well, how do we run it then? Okay, so you added the collection ID, which will make sure the map has downloaded. Important, this has to be downloaded to work. It'll do that on its own if you insert the workshop collection ID. If you don't insert that ID, it will refuse to work. Next, and here you can insert the map name. Most likely creator will just use the name right here. This probably works just fine, so just insert GM Golden City Day with your underscores exactly like this. Let's say you're using Mobinix, and it's GM_Mobinix_V3, if I'm not mistaken. Well, that's it, you now have selected your map, you've set up your workshop collection, you can now close this, save it, you can click it once or right click rename. You can make the txt a .bat file. Yes, you can double click it and it will run the server. But hold your horses, you're not done quite yet. So as you can see, it's now running the server mighty fine, you would think. But you will be able to connect to the server. You will obviously be able to, because it's running on your system. But right here is my public IP, which will be partially hidden. Try connecting using this public IP to the server. I will let you know how you can do that right now. So I'll now open Gary's mod just to demonstrate my point. So we'll open this. It will now be loading for a quick second. Once we're in Garry's Mod, click Find Multiplayer Game. Once my add-ons have fetched, it will find the multiplayer game. Gotta love having Spinnacle Mechanical Storage, aka hard drives. Click Legacy Browser, click Favorites, right click. Add server by IP address, insert your IP address, right. Copy your public IP by dragging across it and then right clicking, so your left click, drag across it and right click. And you insert it like this. Find games at this address, mine is found. You might say, well, why wouldn't mine be? Well, yours is probably gonna display something like unable to connect or just no results at all. Here's why. Open your internet browser. Keep it handy for a second. Press Windows R, the Windows key and the R key at the same time. Type in cmd. In here, in the command prompt, you type ipconfig. Enter. Look for either the Ethernet adapter or look for the wireless LAN adapter. Mine's Ethernet adapter. I will again blur out a lot of this information since it is private. Copy the default gateway or remember it. I'll just remember it. And remember your IPv4 address, not your V6, your V4, which is 192.168.1.110 in my case. If you're using a router, modem combo unit, in Belgium from the great chaps at telenet.be, these assholes have no clue what internet actually means to people, then you will not be able to do this. If you're in Belgium, you're using all these combo units, you're shit out of luck, you're SOL. Why? Because they recently blocked port forwarding again. Luckily, me being a smart guy and all that, joking or not, I installed my own router, which is accessed by 192.168.1.1, as shown right here. And then you can go in here. A lot of this again will be blanked out. It is way too sensitive of information to show on the internet without any regression afterwards. You would look for WAN or Wide Area Network or something like that. In the top bar, in the sidebar, there will be an option for it. Sometimes it will just be simply be called Virtual Server Port Forwarding. On the top bar, most likely gonna be hidden though. It's most likely gonna be hidden. But click Virtual Server on Port Forwarding, you're gonna have to look around for a little bit. You'll find it eventually. And in here, the port forwarding list. You'll have to enter your ports. So I always have to enter a name, which is source server. My port range, which mine is 2705. This is gonna be the same for you. Your local IP, which we just found using the CMD, which is your IPv4 address. That's your local IP. And the protocol has to be on both. So your local IP, so you would enter your local IP, enter your port, and you would enter, well, whatever you would like to call it. There we go. Click plus, click apply. This depends on your router. I cannot exactly explain this. Unless you call me on Discord and you allow me to see all this stuff, but I help you, I won't be able to help you. Call me on Discord, I'm available whenever I'm online. I will try to. I won't promise anything. But there, that now it's port forwarded. Give it a second or two and you should now be able to find the game at this address, which is your public IP address, which is shown in the Garry's Mod server console once it has booted up, right here. Again, blurred out as usual. Double click. And you should now be able to connect to a server. Okay, once you're connecting to it, you will see it will do connect like usual, like any old Garry's Mod server. And you can send your public IP to your friends as well, and they can join. That's it, all hunky-dory. You can now play on your Garry's Mod server as much as you desire, you can blow shit up as much as you desire, and when the server crashes, remember it is all your fault since you were too greedy with the G-bombs. So yeah, if your PC becomes laggy too, it might be that your PC isn't quite powerful enough. It happens, and no PC can run this server perfectly because it's 32-bit and has a memory limit. I won't get into that because it's too complex for this video, it's far out of the scope. But it's never gonna run perfect, so when I would spawn in a lot of this stuff, I want this, I want these, I want to, like, eventually it'll just blow itself up. It's, you know, it's not really meant for that, I don't know. But it works. So you can now invite your friends, you can have a bit of fun, and there will be no admin banning you because you talk too much. Yes, you know where you are if you hear this. So yeah, you can now back to main menu, disconnect, and quit. And that's it. Ta-da, you've made a server. It wasn't that difficult after all, was it? Yeah, there will be a lot of new wires. You can type exit to exit out of it. You'll have to close all the prompts because they always keep restarting. It's like, you know, when it crashes, it automatically restarts. Well, again, a little trick of mine. So once you're done with that, you're pretty much done with all of it. You can launch that will let. If at some point it ceases to connect, they'll run the Steam update on bat again, and then it should all work. There are other options. You can install ULX and ULIP to get full admin control and like control variables like how much props can be spawned. Remove the vehicle limit. If you really want to see that, let me know in the comments down below. I will make a video if at least 10 people ask for it. Might not sound like a lot, but for me it is. Anyhow, hope you all enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you leave a nice like. And as always, appreciate it if you think this is fantastic content. You can also leave a subscribe. Much appreciated once again. See you all in the next one. This was a bit of a new thing I did. I don't usually do how-tos, but I've done a couple and I quite like doing them. So yeah, you will see these once I feel like some subject has to be covered properly. Because yes, you might hear this through the tone of this video. I'm seriously pissed off at the incompetent dick swaps who make how-tos. I am seriously not happy about it. That's why I'm trying to do this the right way. Well, it might sound like I'm an asshole. Maybe I am, who knows. Anyhow, see you all the next time.